Hi guys, this is Mallikarjun here. In today's session, I'm going to explain you how to install Oracle Enterprise Linux 8 in VMware workstation. Precisely, I'm going to install OEL Oracle Enterprise Linux 8.2. So, I already downloaded OEL 8.2. This is the ISO image. So, one can download it from Oracle eDelivery or OTN site. So my ISO is ready, so let's get started with the installation process. Click on this virtual box, select this typical, continue, and select the ISO image. So already ISO image OEL 8.2 is selected here. If you want to browse it once again, so go to your particular OEL file location, select that ISO image and click OK and continue. And give the machine name. I'll go to track 8 and then select the path where you want to install this OEL 8. I'm going to install on my software location. I'll click on next and select the size, whatever size you can give, and give this it virtual disk into multiple files for the performance improvement or better performance, and click on finish. So rack 8 configuration is done and it's going to boot now. Yeah, here it is going on now. So click on this first option, install Oracle Linux 8.2, and second option is test media, the test whether ISO image is correct or not. So I know it's correct because I only downloaded it. So I'm going ahead with the installation. Click enter. Yeah, it's going on. So you can see the read the messages. This lengthy process, it'll take a couple of minutes. Yeah, it's starting the installer in a minute. Now the interaction screen comes, so select the language. So I'm selecting default English language, continue. Then the installation summary comes. So in the installation summary, you need to make sure everything is passed. So see here, installation directory, it is giving some error messages. So click on that installation directory. So that is installation destination. So select the particular hard disk or hard drive, whatever you selected. So click OK. And then again, not selected, so select the disk, click OK. Saving the storage configuration, see now it is passed. So make sure, you know, go on each one of them and then make sure everything is correct before proceeding with the installation. So keyboard, US English, correct. Then installation source, yeah, this is OEL base image, what I selected, that's correct. And installation directory, so already selected virtual hard disk, and then support language English we already selected. Software selection, so this is very important part. So you have to select server with GUI. So if you want your desktop mode, GUI mode, so you have to go out with this one. If you go out with any other option, server or minimal little workstation, station or you know custom operating system and virtualization, you won't get a GUI mode. And make sure you select the development tools. And anything else, I'm just going through. Yeah, that's it. Make sure you select this server with GUI and then development tools. These libraries are very important. So just select and click OK. And then you know, checking for dependencies. Once the software selection is done, so click on date and time. Select desired your location. Okay, then you can continue. If you want to configure your network and host, click on this network and give your host name and IP address. For time being, I'm giving my host name, that's it. So I'm not going to give IP address, I will take care of it once. You can click on this configuration and go with this IP configuration. I don't want to go with IP configuration right now. I'll just give the host name and then I'll continue the installation. Once the installation is done, so then I will proceed with the post configuration steps. So now after all this setup, you just click on installation. So it will do pre-checks and installation and then the post checks. Three phases it will do. So now it's creating all these file systems and pre-checks. So meantime you can set your root password. Click OK. Root password is set. And then if you want to create any alternate users, and then you can go ahead with creating the users. So right now I'm not going to create any users. So it will do all the formatting and it will download all the packages and it will set up all the repositories and RPMs, and then it will start installing with all those RPMs. Once the RPMs are installed and then the configuration is done and kernel setup is done, so it will do some post configuration checks and then it will finally ask you to reboot the server, so that you know it will conclude the installation of Oracle Linux. So right now it is in pre-checks. It is doing a couple of pre-checks like formatting the disk and configuring the files and downloading the RPMs and setting up the repositories and you know ready for installing all those RPMs. So the preparation phase is done and then now it is started installing with all the RPMs. You can see the screen here, right? Installing all the RPMs. So right now 1451 RPMs now it is going to install. So this installation will take longer time, and then now we can come back after a few minutes. Once the installation is done, it will go with the post validation and post checks, and then you know I'll ask for the reboot. So we'll come back after a few minutes. Let's see what's the status. Okay, yeah, here you go. So installation of all the RPMs is almost done. Yeah, almost done. And then now it is configuring all the kernel parameters. When the configuration is done, it will start with the post-step verification. So when the post-step verification is done, it will ask us to reboot the server. Let's wait for a few more minutes. Again, it is configuring a few more kernel RPMs and the post configuration for those major RPMs. Finally, the initrmf file it is generating for the booting. Okay, so now the installation is completed and then it is asking us to reboot. Let's click on reboot. And then it is asking us to select whichever the grub command mode, whichever the kernel you want to select, or it will go with the default option. Now it is went ahead with the default option. Now it is starting the VM.
will take few minutes. Let's wait for a few more minutes, then the server will be ready. Yeah, now the server is booted and a few more configuration, license information and agreement. You need to accept, you know, accept this license. You can just accept license agreement and then click OK. Yeah, then finish configuration. Okay, I started booting the server. Yeah, you can see the welcome screen. Click next. Click next. Skip and create user. Next. Provide the password for that user. Next. Start using a Linux server. These all are like one time setup. Once you do all this setup, so you no need to do it every time whenever you boot. This is first time installation, it is taking a pretty long time than the expected. Yeah, I logged in with Mallikarjun user. Here you go. So we are into login page now. So you were already logged into server. I just close this. This is trying to register your system to Oracle site or satellite server for updates. So I don't want to do this any update or any kernel update or any RPM update from the satellite. So I'm just closing this. Here you go. So you done with the installation and logged into server and quickly check the host name and IP address. So I'm just opening the terminal. Here you go. You have to go with the activities and then check whatever the application you want. So the terminal is ready. I'm just typing host name just to verify my host name. Rack 8 is my host name. Yeah. So I have not configured any IP address, so this I will take care as a port step. So that's it, that's pretty much simple. So installation is pretty straightforward.